sono Elisa di Del Pilates di Vicenza. Quest'oggi iniziamo una serie di interviste con i professionisti del Pilates per capire cosa succede in questo particolare periodo in cui siamo tutti coinvolti in una situazione molto particolare. La nostra ospite di oggi è Shari Berkowitz, che salutiamo. Thank you, Shari, for being here.
I'm so glad to be here. Thank you for having me. I'm Shari Berkowitz. I'm from New York in the United States. Gosh, I'm a Pilates teacher of teachers, as well as a biomechanist and ergonomist. And I study or research musculoskeletal disorders and how we become dysfunctional and how we can return to function. Pretty useful for Pilates. I started teaching online about 8 years ago because I work primarily with Pilates teachers, and I'd work with teachers from all over the world, and they say, oh, I wish I could have a session with you. And I thought, well, you can. Let's use modern technology. And everybody was very afraid of it. And I have to say, I was afraid of it too. But then I decided, enough with the fear, just learn. And it's become something that I teach every single day on, or almost every single day on, and teach teachers all over the world. So that's been great. Because I do that, and because I'm known for answering questions to anybody, for anybody, whenever they ask a question, I don't have to ever have met you, I will answer what your question is. Because of that, around March 10th, I started getting a lot of emails and messages from Pilates teachers all over the world saying, Shari, you know about teaching on video. Can you teach me? Can I schedule a session with you? I'll pay you whatever. And I thought, my God, this is ridiculous. I was getting one message after another. I'm like, there's a desperate need. You are not paying me whatever. I must do a webinar. So I did this webinar on remote and video teaching. And with that, I've been getting, initially I was fielding so many people's emails of their very big concern, their fear of they're going to lose their businesses or lose connections with people, just the desire to connect with people. And how could they get online and even teach a little bit and connect with people? And so that was a pretty heavy time of having hundreds of messages from every day of people with lots of fear and concern. That's why I did that particular webinar, because I wanted to empower people and be like, you can teach, you can connect with people, just like we are right now. But you could teach and you could make some income if that's possible. If it's not possible, you could teach for nothing and still get the fulfillment out of it. And so then it went from these panicked emails to these excited emails, and then people who then felt like, oh my God, I think I can do this, I could do something, to mm-hmm. then really calm emails from teachers all over the place saying, all right, I'm not going to make a lot of money. I still have concerns, but at least I'm connecting with people. Or some people, I am making a lot of money and I feel great and I'm connecting with people. But I think then the bottom line becomes, we could still connect with people. We could still feel and actually be vital. So it's been a really interesting position to be in, to be connected with so many Pilates teachers from all over the world. Yeah, there's been a remarkable shift, I think, or from what's the feedback I'm getting of mm-hmm. people who work of being afraid. I'm not sure I could do this. Oh, my first session then might be not so good, to then the shift of empowerment and feeling like, oh, I can do this, and oh, I'm getting better at this, and my clients are accepting this. Some people are telling me that every single one of their clients is online with them doing sessions. Other people have a little harder time, that some of their clients don't want to do online sessions, or they don't want to do privates, and they don't want to work on the mat. They only want to work on the reformer or so. But there has been a shift. Once you try online or anything new, literally anything new, one time, then by the second time, it's much easier to accomplish. You already acclimate to it. And so there has been this remarkable shift online already.
What's your position on that? I mean, how do you see that? Do you feel online classes can be as effective and useful to clients as the one online?
Well, I think right now that we have to consider that anything is effective. Like, anything is enough. It doesn't have to be great. You're not going to be an expert on it. I've been doing it almost every day for 8 years. It's that's not the expectation I think one should have of themselves when they're starting online, that it's going to be that they're going to feel that in tune with it, like maybe I am. So anything is good, and a beginning is a beginning, and then you grow upon that. Is it as effective in the long run as in studio work? It depends on your methodology of teaching, what it is that you are looking for and what you're cueing. But hands-on is always something that's going to be very valuable, and that's not possible to have on these online sessions. So you have to develop different methodology or different methods of teaching to become effective. Ultimately, when this period of time passes, I hope that everybody will return to the studio, because in the studio it is much more effective. But if it's not available to one, that we should really encourage doing online work. With that, I want to say for those people who have clients who are not willing to do online, I would just offer them even 10 minutes free, no charge, 10 minutes of what would this experience be. Let me guide you through how to set this up, how to turn it on. And you could talk on the phone first and get each other onto the video. And then 10 minutes for free, the person goes, oh, this is different. Or like, oh, it's so nice to see you. Maybe it's just 20 or 30 minutes on the mat. And that can be great. Again, it gets people connected to each other, which is really important. Humans need connection. And it gets people moving. So it gets your clients moving. It gets you as a teacher to recognize and remember how vital you are, how important what we do is.
How do you see our work developing, and how we can best use this time we have?
We can use this time a couple of ways. One, and our what we do when we're teaching. Two, what we're doing when we're not teaching. And so what we're doing when we're teaching, I think we can develop ways to be more effective teachers. And when you're in a new style of teaching, as the video world is for most people, you realize that you might have to adapt and find different ways of communicating. And those different ways of communicating ultimately can help you be in a more effective teacher. So to use the time while you're teaching to really use all the skills that are available to you and adapt to the moment, which also is empowering. And then the time that you're not teaching, that might be time for continuing education. That might be time for resting. Those of you who do have extra time, it's okay to just relax and not be on the crazy wheel of now I have to teach more, now I have to earn more money, now I have to whatever modern world tells us. There is no more teaching, or there is no more early earning money after a certain amount right now. And so that might be time for contemplation, for reading books, for doing artistic endeavors. And it also might be time for continuing education. Hey, this is a good time for doing anatomy quizzes, for taking some webinars, and they don't have to just be mine. But there's lots of things out there. Take some sessions. I don't know what other people are doing, but I'm doing pay what you can for all of my sessions and classes. So if that means a big $0 to me or 0 euros, fine, work out. Come join for sessions. So there's lots of things to play with in your time that you're not teaching, let alone adapting while you are teaching.
So can you tell us where we can find you? You have a website, you have webinars, lots of materials. Tell us about it.
So my company is The Vertical Workshop. And so that's theverticalworkshop.com. And on my website under Pilates, there's three different sections. There's workouts, continuing education, and teacher training. So right now it would be workouts and continuing education that would be useful. And on there, for the workouts, you'll see private sessions, semi-private sessions, mat classes, reformer and multi-apparatus classes. And these are all live streaming. The classes are also recorded, so you could just do the recordings. And they're all pay what you can. If you see something that you want to take and there is a price or a fee that is not appropriate for you right now, for me, just email me and tell me what would work for you. And this is actually always in life with me, but especially right now.
Thank you so much. Thank you for your time. And we make sure we share your contacts and information with everybody interested. And I'm here to help if translation should be needed. And again, thank you so much. I hope to host you again as we did a few years back once this is over.
I would love it. I just want to wish you, first I should say thank you for having me here, and thank you guys, everybody, for watching. And I just want to wish you and everybody just great health and as much patience and calm as possible during this time. And we can do this. We're doing this. We can do this. We can keep doing this. So I just want to cheer us all on. And thank you, Alita, so much.
Thank you. See you soon. Bye-bye.